Okay, could you tell us about the new, it's a grade six sort of STEM project, isn't it?
Yes. What we're looking at is we're looking at aged care, and that came out of a conversation I had with them about my mum, who was in an aged care home up north. Mum's fairly old, well, was fairly old, mum passed away, but she had a fall, and she was in care for about 7 or 8 months. And I was talking to my sister, who's involved with Mercy Health, who's a nun, and she was talking about some of the older people there and some of the problems they had where they'd had falls. They're in a residential environment, they'd had falls and hadn't been found for quite some time. And so I said to the students, well, you know, what could we do around that? How could we resolve this? What sorts of things would we need to know in order to do something about it? And then I got out the box of sensors and we had a look at the different sensors and talked about what the different sensors do, and then I got them to identify which of those would be useful. And you know, we looked at an accelerometer, we looked at EDA, we looked at
What's an
heart rate,
EDA?
electrodermal, so it's like galvanic skin response, it's a stress response. And then we talked about, well, how would you, so we didn't actually do any measuring or anything else, we just talked about how you would actually use those to do something meaningful. For example, if you think about how people move and they've got an accelerometer on, a quick movement doesn't necessarily mean they've had a fall. So how do you, what other things, what other sensors would you need to verify that or validate that? And so we looked at those, and then we started off with the
So how many
RPMs.
weeks was this? So you're saying we're looking at this, we're talking about it, how long is this taking
That's
this?
about probably maybe 5 or 6 weeks.
Okay.
Yep. Well, not the conversation, it was 5 or 6 weeks to get to the point where we started using the sensors and measuring different signals and talking about what those signals mean. The actual conversation around, well, where do we go, that was about 3 weeks. So we talked about, the initial was, you know, well, this is what's happening, what do we do about it? And yeah, as a part of that too, we explored things like, well, what's the actual cost? You know, what does it cost the Australian government in terms of falls in aged care facilities?
And
Because
did the kids do research as part of that, or you did it?
I had the information because I had the links through to Mercy Health, so I provided that data with them, and we just talked about it. We said, well, you know, it costs $65 million a year. And you know, interesting things like, for example, the first fall is predictive of further falls, usually within 6 months.
Wow.
So, and a whole, well, there was built into that a range of other things that I didn't, one of them I didn't discuss with the students, which was around UTIs or urinary tract infections and changes in gait. But it was an interesting thing that came up for me. That was part of my learning. But we looked at, you know, the different, as I said, the different sensors looked at things like, okay, well, you know, what does it cost? It costs $56 million a year. What does it mean for people who are elderly? Well, it means that if you're aware, and especially in an environment where they're independent living, but they're within a centre, it's really important that care gets to them quickly when they have a fall. But the other part of that is a lot of sort of slips and start falls go unreported, so they're not reporting that first slip or fall they had. And so if you knew that, then you would get in there and put the supports in place. Whereas if you didn't know that, then, you know, as I said, they're predictive of further falls. So 6 months down the track, they have a more serious fall where they usually break their hips. Quite is quite a big one amongst the frail elderly. And anyway, we looked at all that data, we worked out what sensors we were going to use, and then we had to sit down and think about, well, what does a measurement mean? When you're looking at sensors, for example, if you're looking at temperature, how do you break that up? And that's where the conversation around ADCs, you know, digital, analog to digital converters came in. And, you know, we've sort of just reached that point at this stage where we're exploring that particular sensor and how you actually break a signal up into something meaningful.